Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome. Today we bring the Easter season to a festive close with the beautiful solemnity of Pentecost. May the Holy Spirit, who first came to the apostles 2,000 years ago, rest upon each one of us and through us renew the face of the earth. As many state and local protocols change in light of the positive strides being made to combat the coronavirus, we nevertheless strongly recommend that for the time being, masks continue to be worn by all those entering the church, with the exception of children under 2 and those with the prohibitive health difficulties. Please see Father Brian's column in today's bulletin for a better explanation of our rationale at this time. Kindly silence all cell phones and electronic devices before we begin this liturgy, and our opening hymn will be Come Holy Ghost. Please stand.
Since we came together to celebrate the joyous good news that the Lord Jesus is not dead, but raised to new life. In other words, it's 50 days since Easter. It may not seem that long, or perhaps it seems much longer than that. But nonetheless, we come together to lift up our hearts in praise to God at the conclusion of the Easter season, and to mark the sending of the Holy Spirit into the midst of Jesus' friends and the Blessed Virgin Mary, gathered in the upper room some 2,000 years ago, to fill their hearts with the strength that they would need to carry on the Lord's mission, and to touch our hearts as well, now 20 centuries later. Let's begin, as always, by remembering our sins. Lord Jesus, you laid down your life so that we might be ransomed from death. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you promised you would never leave us orphaned. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, with the Father, you sent the Holy Spirit to fill us with divine life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of the world.
Fill now once more the hearts of believers through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When the time for Pentecost was fulfilled, they were all in one place together. And suddenly there came from the sky a noise like a strong driving wind, and it filled the entire house in which they were. Then there appeared to them tongues as of fire, which parted and came to rest on each one of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in different tongues, as the Spirit enabled them to proclaim. Now there were devout Jews from any nation under heaven staying in Jerusalem. At this sound, they gathered in a large crowd, but they were confused, because each one heard them speaking in his own language. They were astounded, and in amazement they asked, "Are not all these people who are speaking Galileans? Then how does each of us hear them in his native language? We are Parthians, Medes, and Elamites, inhabitants of Mesopotamia, Judea, and Cappadocia, Pontus, and Asia, Phrygia, and Pamphylia, Egypt, and the districts of Libya near Cyrene, as well as travelers from Rome, both Jews and converts to Judaism, Cretans and Arabs, yet we hear them speaking in our own tongues." The mighty acts of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, no one can say Jesus is Lord except by the Holy Spirit. There are different kinds of spiritual gifts, but the same Spirit. There are different forms of service, but the same Lord. There are different workings, but the same God, who produces all of them in everyone. To each individual, the manifestation of the Spirit is given for some benefit. As a body is one, though it has many parts, and all the parts of the body, though many, are one body, so also Christ. For in one Spirit we were all baptized into one body, whether Jews or Greeks, slaves or free persons, and we were all given to drink of one Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Father, the Spirit of truth, that proceeds from the Father, he will testify to me. And you also testify, because you have been with me from the beginning. I have much more to tell you, but you cannot bear it now. But when he comes, the Spirit of truth, he will guide you to all truth. He will not speak on his own, but he will speak what he hears, and will declare to you the things that are coming. He will glorify me, because he will take from what is mine and declare it to you. Everything that the Father has is mine. For this reason I told you that he will take from what is mine and declare it to you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
And sit down. No, stand up. Yes. Piece that Laura was singing just before. The Gospel is called the Sequence. It's a part of the liturgy for Pentecost and only one or two other Masses during the course of the year. It's really meant just to accent the tremendous importance of today in the course of the Church's liturgical calendar. Just so you know. Many cultures have what we would call a rite of passage, maybe more than one, a ceremony or ritual of some kind by which a young person formally crosses over into adulthood. Our Jewish sisters and brothers tend to look at a bar mitzvah or bat mitzvah very much that way. And even our own Catholic sacramental life, confirmation is viewed by many people as a step into adult discipleship. There are Native American tribes that are also known for those kind of initiation rites. One such test required a young man to spend an entire night alone in the deep woods, without benefit of fire or wood or even weapons of any kind. The forest was, of course, a very foreboding place, potentially dangerous, particularly at night. Among other threats, the young man might be exposed to mountain lions or other predatory animals. It was without a doubt the longest, most anxious night that teenager had ever experienced. But its purpose was to help the young man learn to trust his own inner resources of courage and endurance. With the first light of dawn breaking, however, the teenager was greeted by a very unexpected revelation. His own father had been right close by, hidden, but very close, throughout the entire night, guarding his son from any genuine danger that might have approached. There with the morning sun just beginning to rise, the father would welcome his son once more into the tribe, now no longer a child, but seen very much as an adult. I think the earliest days of the Church must have been something like that long, fearful night in the dark woods for a Native American teenager. Jesus, who had come to mean absolutely everything to his disciples and inner circle of friends, who of course was brutally taken from them, tortured and crucified, the center of their lives had been torn away and buried in a borrowed tomb. And of course, since that horrible Good Friday, many of them had experienced the most amazing and unexpected of things, namely seeing their master, not dead, but marvelously alive. Seeing him with their own eyes face to face, hearing his voice all over again, enjoying the sweetness of Jesus' company miraculously transformed, raised from the dead. But then, as we know from the story, after 40 days, he was taken away from them again, this time to return to the Father who had sent him. So, despite the exhilaration of experiencing Jesus risen, one has to imagine that at his ascension, the apostles were once again left in disbelief, anxious, confused. How would they ever manage without him? Where should they go now? How were they to begin the work that he had charged them to do? As today's first reading that Christina just shared with us begins, we find them huddled together once again in that upper room somewhere in Jerusalem, that place where they had experienced so much anxiety and uncertainty, so much fear and grief. They're hoping and praying for some kind of guidance and protection. What happens next is, in effect, the greatest gift that the Lord's followers could have hoped to receive, with a house rattling wind and tongues of fire. They learn in no uncertain terms that they are not alone, that the power of the Father and the enduring love of the Son have been with them all along. Like that young Native American boy seeing his own father so close, though he'd been hidden through the dark night. Seeing him there at the end of his frightening night vigil, like him, the disciples received the one who had been promised to them, the Spirit of Truth, who would propel them out of that shuttered room to proclaim the good news they received to a waiting world. The risen Lord had not abandoned his friends to the darkness. He was still, of course, entirely with them, protecting and emboldening them, comforting and reassuring them, guarding and anointing them with his own power. The message, or at least one of the messages of this Pentecost and any Pentecost, is that even though we may think ourselves so very alone, and are there any of us here who haven't experienced some degree of isolation, some feeling of being alone and cut off during these past 16 months? The promise of Pentecost is that nothing can separate us from the love of Christ, who continues to flood our lives and our world with his transforming Spirit. No matter what dangers we ourselves may face, no matter what sickness, what grief, what seemingly insurmountable challenges, we have not been left alone in the dark to fend for ourselves, because Jesus is with us to the very end of time, lavishing his Spirit on each and every heart that will receive him. Stand together. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God,
begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man.
He was crucified under Pontius Pilate.
He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. As children of our Heavenly Father and heirs to the kingdom of his Son, we lift up our prayers in the power of the Holy Spirit.
The response will be, Lord, send us your Spirit. For the Church of God throughout the world, for our shepherds, especially Pope Francis, for all who strive to walk in the footsteps of the risen Christ, may the Spirit be our guide. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, send us your Spirit.
That the peace Jesus bequeathed to his disciples after his resurrection will come to rest on our troubled world, especially the people of India and the Middle East, on our parish, our homes, and our individual lives, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, send us your Spirit.
For all the young people of our parish who will soon receive the Spirit's gift in the sacrament of confirmation, and for Henry Fenio, who is being confirmed this weekend, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, send us your Spirit.
For all who give their time, creativity, resources, and talent in any form of ministry or volunteer service here at St. Lawrence, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, send us your Spirit.
For those who are sick, disabled, or recovering from illness or injury, especially those who are ill with the coronavirus or its aftereffects, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, send us your Spirit.
For our sisters and brothers who have died, especially Elizabeth Jean Elliott, Peter W. Fontaine, Charles Hill, and Elizabeth Coop, may they rise with Christ to a glorious new life which no one can take from them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, send us your Spirit.
Let us command Rose Sangha Dulce, Mildred Whitman, Madeline Dahlia, Mildred Nate Taxis, Senior Rose Millerian Pelletier, James Michael Million, and Helen Lecitra to God's loving embrace as we continue our Eucharist. And for the unspoken needs, we pause to now recall. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us, save your people.
Of course, according to the Acts of the Apostles, the Virgin Mary was present with the Lord's friends in the upper room when the Holy Spirit came. As we continue making our progress through this month of May, let's call on her intercession for ourselves and the whole of our world. As we pray together, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women. Blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Lord of glory, hear our prayers. Open our hearts to receive a fresh outpouring of your Spirit's gifts, that we might help renew the face of the earth. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our offertory hymn will be Send Us Your Spirit.
Thank you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that as promised by your Son, the Holy Spirit may reveal to us more abundantly the hidden mysteries of this sacrifice, and graciously lead us into all truth, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks together to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for bringing your Paschal mystery to completion. You bestowed the Holy Spirit today on those you made your adopted children by uniting them to your only begotten Son. The same Spirit, as the Church came to birth, opened to all peoples the knowledge of God and brought together the many languages of the earth in profession of the one faith. Therefore, overcome with Paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. That you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and John our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostle, Saint Lawrence, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Our communion hymn will be One Bread, One Body.
Amen.
God, who bestow heavenly gifts upon your church, safeguard, we pray, the grace you have given, for the gift of the Holy Spirit poured out upon her may retain all its force, and that this spiritual food may gain her abundance of eternal redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Not unlike the state of New York or the CDC, our bishop's office has issued a new set of recommendations for moving toward a more complete reopening of parish life in our diocese. Father Brian and our staff are examining the recommendations carefully and deciding how best to implement these next steps here in St. Lawrence. As announced earlier, we strongly recommend that masks continue to be worn by all entering the church or parish offices. More details will be available soon, but for the time being, please see Father Brian's column in today's bulletin. Pope Francis has asked that the rosary be prayed each day of May, asking the intercession of the Virgin Mary and bringing the COVID-19 pandemic to an end. All of our parishioners are encouraged to share this worldwide spiritual effort. Kindly leave your weekly offering in one of the baskets on the tables. Though we don't yet have a full congregation in the pews, the generosity of those here in person and those supporting St. Lawrence from home has been a magnificent testament in the solidarity of our parish family in the spirit of stewardship. Be sure to take a copy of the bulletin as you leave. Remember to wash or sanitize your hands at the earliest opportunity, and enjoy the rest of your weekend.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.
Have a lovely evening and a great weekend.